What makes a console 8 bits? And how many bits does your PS4 or Xbox One have? Have you even thought about it? I suppose you haven't. But back in the day, you definitely knew if you were playing on a 16-bit system or a 32-bit system. And when a new console was coming out, you'd be drooling over the advertising, claiming how many bits it was. But what does it really mean? And how come no one ever talks about it anymore? To find out, we must learn a little bit more about computer history and how a processor works. I've noticed a big misconception growing with the rise of retro gaming and indie titles with retro graphics becoming popular. I've heard the term 8-bit graphics being tossed around quite a bit, and while they usually mean graphics in the style of at the time popular 8-bit gaming consoles, it seems sometimes people get the idea that the number of bits represent a particular set of graphical capabilities. The truth is that it actually has nothing to do with the graphics. Let's get back to basics to give you a better understanding of where that mystical number comes from. A computer counts everything in just ones and zeros, the binary system. A number in binary goes up to 1, then carries over to the second digit to store the number 2, using 2 digits, so it looks like number 10 in binary. It's just as how our regular decimal system goes up to 9 before it carries over and becomes 10, with 2 digits. Every digit in decimal represents a power of 10, while in binary a digit represents a power of 2. A binary digit is called a bit. It corresponds to a state of either on or off in an electric circuit. 0 for off, 1 for on. A computer can only really deal with numbers, albeit weird binary numbers, but they represent the same amount of something as if it were written in decimal form. So if we wanted to represent something else than a number, like a character in the alphabet, in a computer program, we will have to do that using a number for each character. For example, 1 through 26 for A to Z. So how many bits do you need to represent those 26 different combinations? Well, since each digit represents a power of 2, that means we need to add 5 bits to make 32 possible combinations. But what if we also would like to distinguish between uppercase and lowercase letters? We need to add a 6th bit to double that to 64. Now we can fit the alphabet in both upper and lower case, and even the digits 0 through 9. That's 62 different characters, only 2 more possibilities left. Not much if you want punctuation and blank spaces and other common things in your text. So maybe we need a 7th bit to double that again to 128 possible combinations. And that is exactly what the American Standards Association did back in 1963 when they created ASCII, a standard way to encode text using computers with 128 different characters, numbers, digit, punctuation, and some control codes, all in 7 bits. Since that power of 2 is derived from the very way computers operate, it can be more efficient to represent data using a number of bits that is a power of 2. So another bit was added when building computers to bring that number up to 8. These 8 bits that belong together to represent something, like a letter in the alphabet, a number, or maybe an instruction to the CPU, are grouped together and called a byte. Computer processors from the 70s and 80s would operate on data 1 byte at a time. They could perform calculations and fetch and store from memory 1 byte per machine instruction. Adding 1 byte to another, store a byte to memory, and so on. A processor that can work on 1 byte at a time, 8 bits, is referred to as an 8-bit CPU, and that is exactly where that number comes from when you talk about your old Atari or Nintendo console being 8 bits. Working with 1 byte at a time can be inefficient when dealing with calculations on larger numbers. Since 8 bits can only really represent the numbers 0 through 255, if you want to work on numbers bigger than that, you will need to use multiple bytes and split the calculation up into smaller parts. This takes time, and there are a lot of cases when you need to calculate something with numbers bigger than 255. So companies began developing CPUs that worked on 2 bytes at a time, 16 bits. More bits per command also made it easier to address larger amounts of memory by storing longer addresses. But there were 8-bit CPUs that could address more memory than 256 different bytes, so it's not the heart of where the bit naming system comes from. The 16-bit games consoles use processors that can work with 16 bits of data at a time. Then the PlayStation and Saturn came along with 32-bit processors. After that, it goes a little cloudy. The marketing divisions of the companies producing competing games consoles started to realize that gamers knew it was about the bits. So if they wanted to sell a games console and make it seem better than what was already out there, they could just sell it as having more bits, usually without actually using that amount of bits inside the processor in the way it's usually meant. The Atari Jaguar was heavily marketed as a 64-bit system in the early 90s, to make it sell in competition with the popular 16 and 32-bit consoles. They were cheating quite a bit to come up with this number though, since the CPU is actually 32 bits, and it talks to its video coprocessor that's also 32 bits. This would, according to Atari, add up to 64 bits. And when consumers caught on, its use in marketing started to fade. The last big console to use the number of bits as a selling point would be the Nintendo 64, which, to its credit, actually used the 64-bit processor. Consoles after that, like the GameCube, Dreamcast, Xbox, never used the bit system to tell the world how great they were. But I remember, I would still see references to bits in various magazines, and friends calling the Dreamcast 128-bit. So, what are we up to now? It must be like 512 bits, or 1024, or even more, right? Well, the truth is, CPUs never really went past 64 bits. There's just never that much use to do calculations on a number bigger than that. 64 bits can store numbers that are so big they just don't make any sense. You can store numbers bigger than 9 quintillion in 64 bits. That is a 9 followed by 18 zeros, more than there are number of grains of sand on Earth. So, how many bits is your PS4? Well, sadly it's just as many bits as your old Nintendo 64.